about graph data structures. The requests are really useful for lots of data in questions. We have to check out the lowest cost path from X to Y. We need a structure to represent the graphs. You have to choose the best one that can depend upon it for the properties of graphs. You have the common queries such as UMV. We discuss mainly about existing metrics and adjacency list and different trade-offs. Let's begin with adjacency metrics. We have to assign each node a number from 0 to vertex minus 1. We have the formula there. A V times V matrix, two-dimensional array of booleans, answer 0. If you have to check if the matrix M is equal to true, two-dimensional. Adjacency matrix properties, you have the running time to get the vertex out of the edge and get the vertex in the edge. Of course, you have to decide, insert or delete. But how will the adjacency matrix derive from an underrated graph? Underrated graphs once will be submitted to the diagonal. We can adapt the presentation for weighted graphs. Instead of boolean, the store number is L. They need some values to represent on an edge. We have adjacency list. We have to assign each node a number from 0 to V minus 1. An array at length V in which each entry stores the list of all adjacent vertices. Adjacency list properties. We have the running time to get all the vertex out of the edge, where D is degree of vertex. You have to get all the vertex in the edges, decide some edges exist, insert or delete. If you check from algorithm annotation, you have to represent graphs. If you implement some useful non-trivial algorithms, topological sort and the shortest path algorithms, we have related such to demand such path exists, depth first search and breadth first search. So, topological sort, given the AG order, the vertices, so every vertex become before all its neighbors. As you can see from this relation, X, Y, Z has 3 degrees. We have to label a mark. Each vertex is with its degree could arrive in a field of vertex. And could also do this data structure. When there are other vertices not yet to output, we have to choose the degree of 0, output V, and remove it from graph, and for each vertex of U against 2V. We have to administration there within degree and node, and that removed or not. Maybe if we math 126 and let's 144 to XYZ, they will be 0, 2, 1, and 3 to the last one, XYZ. If you check the notice, the nearest vertex with degree of 0 to start will always have at least 1 because its styles are among the vertices with the same degree of 0 and they can be broken arbitrarily. There can be more than one concurrent test answer by definition depending on the graph. You can see from the pseudocode, we have initialized I is equal to 0 to check if I is less the number of vertices and increment it. Then the vertices become the new degree 0. Of course, the worst in case time running time will be initialization of assumed adjacency list, the sum fall in to find new vertices and decrements. But to keep it better, you have to avoid frustration for 0 degree node every time. You have to keep the pending 0 nodes in the list like we have back table. You have to order preprocessor them effects, output and input, and sometimes delete or remove or add can be the big of 1, which is constant time. Sometimes we use a query. We have to label each vertex with degree. Sometimes and query can be 0 degree nodes. Now, while the queries are empty, we have to use V sealed with the query. You have an example now of topological sort using query. ABC nodes. D. You need to check for running time now. The total of this pseudocode would be much better for sparse graph. Last one much better for the traverse graphs. We have graph traversals. We use depth and breadth first searches. We have introductory example of graph traversals. Our computer systematically found a new path through the maze. Here with source and destination. In graph terminology, we have to find a path from over the Sonata, from source designations as if the mace and the notes. Yes, the main idea is to repeatedly explore and keep track of just the vertices and to mark each vertex with easy so we don't process them each more than once. Use depth for search defense. You have to explore as far as possible along each branch before backtracking, or repeatedly explore just the vertices using the mark of each vertex we visit so we don't process them each more than once. We have a simple set of code. But if you try using a query, yeah, the same idea is to repeatedly explore and keep track of the each vertex we visit so we don't process them each more than once. We use breadth first to explore the neighbors first before moving to the next level of neighbors. And repeatedly explore adjacent vertices using mark each vertex you visit so we don't process each more than once. Even in several set of code. You can see if we have a question now. Possible order of visiting the nodes. We have mainly possibilities. In this case, we have 4. Check them if they are correct or not. We have assuming that the add remove methods are big of 1. In charge of rest is using adjacent list presentation. The order of we traverse depends entirely on add remove, DFS, and BFS. We have to use comparison to check the shortest path, which is the shortest path from x to y, and which is more than one possible path. Which one can use less space in finding path? And the third approach is IDFS or iterative dependent search. We can use DFS or disallow recursion more than k levels. If that fails, increment k and start the entire space all over again. Like BFS, first find shortest path, but DFS uses less space. The use of graph traversal. We can use graph traversal to answer what are the vertices reachable from starting vertex. Undirected graph connected, a directed graph still unconnected. But what we want to actually put the path instead of marking, we can store the next node along the path. When you reach the goal, you have to follow path fields back to where we started and reverse the answer. If you just want path length, we could put integer distance additional instead of ones. A saving path. Our graph traversal can answer the reachability question if there is a node to x or y. But what you want to put it, output the path. Instead of just marking a node, of course, you have the main idea to output directly the node, but it's way more better to do this. We have to start the previous node of the path. When we reach that goal, we have to follow the path back when we started the main root vertices, and with just the path length, we could put the teacher distance additional instead. So we are at the end one, so thank you for listening to me. If you have a question, please write me down below in the comments. And the network guys, if you have any problems today, please let me know and I will answer them below in the comments. Thank you.